before the dinner actually happens.
All right, Brian Stelter, thank you so much.
Thanks.
Really appreciate you joining us. And now I want to talk more about this with A. Scott Bolden. He's the former chairman of the Democratic Party in Washington, D.C., and CNN political commentator Alice Stewart. She is a Republican strategist. We also have CNN political commentator Ryan Lizza, Washington correspondent for The New Yorker. And I want you all to actually listen to that moment that Brian Stelter was talking about, President Obama talking about Donald Trump.
Donald Trump is here tonight. No one is happier, no one is prouder to put this birth certificate matter to rest than the Donald. And that's because he can finally get back to focusing on the issues that matter. Like, did we fake the moon landing? What really happened in Roswell? And where are Biggie and Tupac?
No love lost at that point in time, for sure, because Donald Trump, really one of the original birthers, trying really, you know, spearheading that effort to get President Obama to release his birth certificate. So, Ryan Lizza, I mean, what do you make of this? Because it almost seemed as if there was no way that Donald Trump, if he really did want to put the press in this role as being so in opposition to him, it didn't really seem that it would make sense for him to attend this dinner.
Yeah, I was in the room that night, where, and that was one of the most vicious roastings I've ever seen. And it was one of the reasons I actually thought that Trump might want to go this year, is to sort of return to that dinner and, you know, sort of come full circle as the conquering hero of the dinner. Look, after the last month of Trump's statements about the press, defining the media as the enemy of the American people, mocking the First Amendment this week at CPAC, as you pointed out, Brianna, accusing reporters of making up sources with no evidence. I don't think that that dinner was the appropriate forum for the press and the president. There's a moment in that dinner where everyone stands up and toasts the president. And my own opinion is, you know, this is not a time to be toasting someone who calls you the enemy of the American people. The relationship with the press has obviously gotten very adversarial. And, you know, look, maybe we could have seen a detente between now and the dinner, and the dinner could have been a point where Trump stopped those attacks and it was reasonable for everyone to be in the same room. But, you know, as I said to you before, I think he's done everyone a favor here by not going. He's made it less awkward for the journalists that cover the White House to be able to just go to that dinner, celebrate the award winners that are honored at that dinner, celebrate the young scholarship winners that are honored at that dinner. And I, you know, I frankly, I was not planning on attending. If you know, I've been a member of the White House Correspondents Association since 2001. I've been to most of the dinners, but I don't think it would have been appropriate this year to go if Trump had been there. That's my own view.
Alice, what do you think about that? That idea that journalists would not attend or think that it's appropriate to go, if you're to hold that up against just a respect for the institution, even if Donald Trump doesn't appear to respect the institution of the press?
Well, we've already heard many people are canceling their parties. A lot of, certainly, the celebrities aren't coming. I've heard of other journalists that feel the same way Ryan does in terms of toasting someone who has roasted you every opportunity. You have to remember, though, this is not something new. We can go back to the campaign days. Donald Trump truly feels as though the media has been out to get him. They're not reporting on things accurately. That is why he goes to Twitter and gets his message out, bypassing the media, getting his message directly to the people. That's also why he is doing more campaign style events, to get out there with the people and get his message out there directly to them. And he doesn't miss the opportunity while he's there with his people to criticize and take down the media with the crowd. They enjoy that, and it generates his base. That being said, as a former journalist, I think it's important what the role of the press is. I think it's critical for a free democracy to have that check and balance on the government and open and transparency with the government. And also, it's not, you know, forgotten here, Democrats, for the first time in quite some time, have some wind in their sail today with Tom Perez being the new DNC chair. And Republicans have been fighting, this administration has been fighting Russia news every turn. And Donald Trump is not...
And I'm sorry to jump in there, Alice. Yeah. I just want to get A. Scott Bolden in here because I only have about 30 seconds left. That's not what we're talking about, Scott.
Right.
We're now talking about this. Is this just Donald Trump expertly changing the subject?
Maybe, but he's also driving the war on the media. This is just another segment. Remember, he didn't go to a presidential debate during the primary. He seems to feel that if he doesn't show up, he's somehow hurting his adversary, but this is his war against the media. And I'll be honest with you, the best response for the White House Correspondents Association would be to have the most successful dinner ever. Maybe Alec Baldwin can come in character, the celebrities can come, and Ryan can come back to the dinner now because he's not there. Yeah. He's not coming.
Just quickly.
Right, I'm sorry, Ryan. I would let you, but we're really out of time. Ryan, Liza, Alice, Stewart, Scott, thank you so much for that.
Thank you.
Tomorrow.